Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Ashland Middle School. It's Ashland Legion Baseball on HCAM Television in Hopkinton or WACA-TV in Ashland. Connor Donovan on camera, Tom Nappy on the call as Ashland Post 77 gets ready for their 15th game of the regular season. They come into today's contest with a record of 6-7-1, while Natick Post 107 comes in with a record of 4-11. Ashland got a couple wins over the past few days, and they have fought their way back into the playoff race, and they look to get a very important win here. Post 77 most likely has to win out if they do want a shot at the playoffs. The pitcher today for Ashland Post 77 will be Jeff Holler getting the start. Let's take a look at the diamond around Jeff Holler. Mike Messier is his battery mate behind the plate. Nick Burns over at first base. Michael Krupe at second base. Nick Porter the shortstop. Brendan Thurber at third. From left to right, it's Greg Holler, Andrew Keim, and Alex Cohen. And now for the Natick batting order, Rick White, the designated hitter, will lead things off, and he will be followed up by Hunter Mayer, the right fielder. Jared Abruzzese, the center fielder. Kennedy Wilson, the shortstop, will bat fourth. Center fielder Ryan Welby will bat fifth. Jack Fazio, the third baseman, is batting seventh. Nick Wilson, the catcher, batting eighth. And Christian Buschetto, the second baseman, batting ninth. As the first hitter steps in, and we are set for baseball. Rick White awaits the pitch. Wind up and the pitch, and that is just low, 1-0. White, Mayer, Abruzzese, the first three hitters due up this inning for Natick. Wind up and the pitch, down low. A 2-0 count. Rick White out of Natick High School. There's a strike. Rick's set to graduate after next school year. Wind up in the pitch from Holler. Swinging strike. Fouled away. 2-2. And it is very important to take advantage of games like this to keep on fighting in the playoff hunt. It's that pitch outside. And Post 77, they have not played well at home this season. They've actually played better overall on the road. Wind up and the pitch. And this is a pop fly over towards shallow right field. Ranging over to make the catch is Alex Cohen, and there is one away. That'll bring up Hunter Mayer, right fielder. Wind up and the pitch. This is hit in the air towards center field. Ranging over to make the catch is Andrew Keim, two away. Now Jared Abruzzese coming to the plate at a Natick High School, graduate after next school year. Holler winds and deals. There's a strike. Interesting coaching situation today. Scott Soderberg, the assistant coach, leading Ashland Post 77 today. Head coach Derek Johnson is out of the office. That one's fouled away, 0-2. And for Natick, they are led by head assistant coach today, who's acting as the head coach, Chris Darcy. Jim Tomasetti is the original head coach for Natick, but two very good assistant coaches taking over today. One and two is the count. Two away as Holler is set to deal. That is just low, 2-2. It's pretty nice weather here today. It was very humid and hot earlier. Temperatures got in the mid-90s. They have since dropped towards the mid-80s, and there's a nice breeze. There is thunderstorms in the area, but they are off to the west as Brutz SC takes strike three. And Natick post 107 goes down 1-2-3 in the top of the first. We will head to the bottom of the first inning next. Bottom half of the first inning, Ashland post 77 coming to the plate. Let's take a look at the batting order. Nick Porter will lead things off and play shortstop. Brendan Thurber batting second, playing third base. Greg Haller batting third, playing left field. Nick Burns, the cleanup hitter, playing first. Alex Cohen batting fifth, playing right field. Andrew Kine batting sixth, playing center field. Mike Messier, the catcher. And Michael Krupe playing second base, batting eighth. Brendan Wolf batting ninth as their strike one. So Porter, Thurber, Haller do up this inning. Adam Mooney, the pitcher for Natick, winds and deals. That is just high, 1-1. Adam Mooney out of Natick High School, graduate after next school year. We'll take a look at the Natick Diamond in just a moment as this is fouled away, 1-2. Adam Mooney is the pitcher. His battery mate Nick Wilson over at first, Kyle Dombrowski. Christian Boschetto, the second baseman. Kennedy Wilson at third, shortstop. Jack Fazio, the third baseman. As this is a pop fly in the air above the head of the first baseman, and he makes the catch. One away. Jared Abruzzese over in left field. Ryan will be the center fielder. And then over in right field, it is Hunter Mayer. As Brendan Thurber steps in to face Adam Mooney. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. 0-1. Post 77, they have been hitting the ball pretty well lately. That's fouled away. Their last home game, they got a nice win against Tingsboro. Wind up and the pitch. And this takes a couple hops on the infield grass. Fielded that short, throw to first, two away. It'll bring Greg Haller to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. Breaking pitch. Nice drop. 0-1. Mooney set to deliver. That one's just high. Mooney winds and deals. That one's down low, 2-1. Wind up and the pitch. And there's a nice breaking pitch, but it stayed up high, 3-1. You're going to see a lot of breaking pitches out of Adam Mooney. Goes with a fastball there, followed away, 3-2. Nick Burns due up, shall Greg Haller reach? Wind up and the pitch. And that is a called strike. And Ashland will go down, 1-2-3. We head to the second inning. It's a scoreless game between Natick and Ashland. Top half of the second inning. As Natick will come back up to the plate. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Cornerstone at Milford, a new senior community featuring apartment living with innovative programs, services, transportation to help seniors stay independent. Conveniently located on Route 109 near 495. More at cornerstonemilford.com. The windup and the pitch by Holler is in there for a strike. 0-1 to Kennedy Wilson, the shortstop. Holler to the set, delivers. And that is hit into right field. That'll drop in for a base hit and a leadoff single for Kennedy Wilson. Now Ryan Welby, the center fielder, will step in. So runner on first, no outs. Runner is leading. Holler set to deliver. Down low, got by Messier. Runner from first is going to advance to second with no throw. That pitch didn't look too wild to me. I'm going to call that a pass ball. It was low, no doubt about that. But it looked like it came out of the catcher's glove. Wind up and the pitch. There's another low ball, 2-0. Holler working from the stretch, man on second, no outs. That is fouled away, 2-1. He winds and deals. On the ground, up the middle, and it is handled by the second baseman. Throw to first, and they get the runner. Call that a sacrifice ground out for Ryan Welby. Wilson moves up to third, and that'll bring up Kyle Dombrowski. The righty steps in and awaits the pitch. Dombrowski has some good power. There's a strike one. Dombrowski graduated Natick High School this year. Holler from the stretch. And this is chopped foul. 0-2. Holler delivers. Up the left side, past the glove of Brendan Thurber, and a run will score. And actually, it was Nick Porter on the dive. An RBI single for Dombrowski. That'll bring up Jack Fazio to the plate. So one out. RBI single for Dombrowski, and it's 1-0 Natick. That pitch outside, 1-0 to Fazio. Holler delivers outside. Runner leading off of first. There's a strike. Two and one. And this is up the third base side. Fair ball. Thurber fields it. Throw to second. They get one. Nice job by Thurber as he gets the lead runner. So Fazio reaches on the 5-4 fielder's choice. Nick Wilson to the plate. Runner taking off from first, throw down, gets into center field, and the runner will stay put at second base. Stolen base for Fazio. Two outs and a runner on second. Holler deals. That's up high. One and one count. Holler awaits the sign. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit high in the air towards the wall in center field. And ranging back to make the catch is Andrew Keim. And that will retire the side. But Natick does score a run. It is 1-0 post 107 leading Ashland as we head to the bottom of the second. Bottom of the second inning, 4-5 and 6, two up for post 77. Nick Burns, Alex Cohen, Andrew Keim. Ashland trailing Natick 1-0 as we enter this inning. Adam Mooney back out for another inning of work. After Natick was able to plate a run in the top of the second, an RBI single by Kyle Dombrowski. Scored Kennedy Wilson. The windup and the pitch is in there for a strike to Nick Burns. Burns really the number one power threat for this post 77 squad. And on a breaking pitch, he will take a strike, it looks like. Not a very clear sign by the umpire. The leg lift and the pitch. On the ground, up the middle, takes a couple hops on the infield grass and will get by the second baseman, Christian Boschetto. So the leadoff man is on. That'll bring up Alex Cohen. For those of you just joining us, you're watching Ashland Legion Baseball on either HCAM in Hopkinton or WACA-TV in Ashland. Connor Donovan on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. Adam Mooney set to deliver to Alex Cohen, the windup and the pitch. Down low and briefly got away from Nick Wilson, but he quickly gathers it up. Mooney working from the stretch, Burns over at first. Burns does have speed and is a threat to steal. And this is a little chop into right field. That'll drop in for a base hit. Runners on first and second. Two straight singles to start things off for post 77. And now Andrew Keim will step into the batter's box. Good piece of hitting there by Cohen. Didn't try to overpower, just put it right in the gap over in right field. Breaking pitch up high, 1-0. A lot of sinker balls by Mooney. Both runners leading. Mooney takes a look at second and delivers. This is hit high in the air. It is in foul territory and out of play. 1-1. Mike Messier due up on deck. Mooney set the deal. Bunt is going to be a strike. See if Keim bunts again here. And he won't. He'll hit a liner over the glove of Christian Boschetto. Runner being waved around. And the throw in is going to be cut off. One run is in to score. An RBI single for Andrew Keim. Nick Burns comes around as Alex Cohen pushes up to third. Still no outs. Runners on the corners. Mike Messier coming to the plate. Mooney again from the stretch. Checking at first, runner back. Andrew Keim, he has really been a tremendous hitter for Post 77 this season. That one just outside. Mooney set to deliver. There's another outside pitch. Late strike call, 1-1. Mooney set to deliver. This is a liner down the third baseline, foul. 1-2. This is a big opportunity for Post 77 to really take control of this game. Natick has had a good amount of pitching struggles this season. As this is hit high in the air, foul territory, and caught. Making the catch, third baseman, Jack Fazio, one away. That was right over by us, as Michael Krupe, the second baseman, will step in. The lefty awaits the pitch. Checking at first, runner back safe. Brendan Wolf in the ninth spot in the lineup today as a DH. First pitch to Krupe is a sinker for strike one. Mooney awaits the sign. That's fouled away, 0-2. Checking at first, runner slides back just safe. From the stretch. Runner taking off from first. Throw down is going to be in time, but the runner from third comes home, but it doesn't matter as that was the third out. And we will head to the third inning. It is a 1-1 ball game. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem. Eliminate your pest problem. A family-owned business. You can call them at 508-366-1820 or find them online at WPCPest.com. Top of the third inning. The windup and the pitch. Down low, 1-0. Hitter at the plate is second baseman Christian Bachetto. Jeff Haller set to deliver to Bachetto. There's a pitch down low, 2-0. Bachetto, White, Mooney. Excuse me, Bachetto, White, and Mayer are the three due up for Natick. That is foul. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is a fair ball up the middle and bobbled by Haller, and he has no throw. Bachetto reaches on the error. I'll bring up Rick White. Runner leading off of first. Holler set to deliver. Checking at first, runner back. Rick White flew out his first time up. Holler deals, runner takes off from first, and it gets away from Messier, an easy steal. That pitch was in the dirt. Holler delivers. There's a strike, 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. Just high. Holler on the 2-1. We'll step off the mound as Bruschetto gets back to the second base bag. Holler delivers down low in the dirt. Messier keeps it in front of him. A nice job. There'll be a throw. And a nice grab by Porter. Throw was a little bit away from Kruppi, and Porter jumped over the runner to make sure it did not get into the outfield. Holler delivers. That one's up high. Rick White draws the walk. First walk of the game given up by Jeff Holler. And now Hunter Mayer will step in. Flew out his last time up. Holler steps off the second base bag and looks towards second base. Steps off the pitcher's mound and looks towards second base. Excuse me. Check in at second once again. Did not throw. There's a strike. Holler, a long glare towards second base before stepping off the mound again. Once again, no throw. See Bruschetto maybe in his head a little bit. The bunt is a slow roller up the middle, a good bunt. Throw to first, they get him. Throw to third, the runner was off the bag, and they almost got him, but he slides back just safe. White moves up to second, a sacrifice ground out. Sacrifice one to three for the first out. Runners on second and third now with one out for Natick. Jared Abruzzese will step in. He struck out his last time up in the first. Wind up and the pitch up high. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away. Holler set the deal. Up high. Wind up and the pitch. Fastball up high. Little jam here for Holler. 3-1 to Brutzessi. There's the walk. Bases loaded, one out. Well, this is a desperation game for Ashland to try to get into the playoff mix as catcher Mike Messier and third baseman Brendan Thurber will have some words with Jeff Haller. You'll wonder what the leash is with pitchers at this point in the season. This is the last week of the regular season. You got this and three games after, and pretty much you're in a situation where you really need to win out if you want any hope of getting in. Wind up and the pitch to Kennedy Wilson is in there for a strike. Jeff Haller, of course, out of Hopkinton High School, as this is fouled away. 0-2. Big thank you to the Natick third base coach for helping us out there. Ball was coming right for us. If anything, it would have hit Connor, though, so it's not too big of a deal. As that pitch is down low. The 1-2 pitch. That one's outside, 2-2. Haller winds and deals. Breaking pitch just high, full count. Big pitch right here. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit into right field above the glove of Nick Burns. One run in, second run coming around. And the throw in is going to be right to Burns. Two-run score on the two RBI single by Kennedy Wilson. Bachetto and White come around, and it is a 3-1 ball game. Abruzzese up to third. Ryan Welby to the plate, still one out in the inning. Checking at first, runner back. Runner sliding back there. Welby hit a sacrifice ground out his last time up, last inning, top of the second. Wind up and the pitch, just high. 1-0. And there was some thunderstorms just to the west of us, so a pretty cool breeze now on the field. It was a very humid day, and you could feel the cool air that came in. Fortunately, no thunderstorms here as that pitch up high, and the runner from first took off to second. Messier threw down to third to make sure Abruzzese wasn't going anywhere. Stolen base for Wilson. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. 2-1 on Welby. Swinging strike, 2-2. Jeff Haller will likely be the Hillers' top starter next year. Wind up and the pitch. A little bloop shot right back to Haller, and he'll catch the little pop fly for the second out. That was a big out there. Kyle Dombrowski will step in. He hit an RBI single his last time up. Drove in Kennedy Wilson. Wind up and the pitch. Ball up high to the righty. Haller set to deliver. And this is crushed, hit high in the air towards center field, towards the wall, and it's going to be handled by Andrew Keim as he runs all the way back to the fence. What a catch by Keim. Covered a lot of field to get to that one, but Natick does come up with two runs. It's 3-1, post 107 leading Ashland as we head to the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third, Ashland trailing Natick 3-1. Due up for post 77, 9-1-2. Brendan Wolf, Nick Porter, and Brendan Thurber to face Adam Mooney. As Wolf will step in, Mooney set to deliver. Wind up and the pitch. Just outside, 1-0. Mooney winds and deals. Check swing, did he hold? Yes, he did. 2-0. Oh no, excuse me. 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. Bunt fouled away. One and two count. Wind up and the pitch. Air strike three, Wolf strikes out. One away. That'll bring up Nick Porter. Wolf was frustrated that he chased that one. Let's take a look at the standings in Zone 5. We'll start off with Zone 5A. Hudson at the top, 13-2. Newton 10-4 in second. Sudbury 9-7. Then you got Ashland at 6-7-1. And then Natick at the bottom at 4-11. As there's a swinging strike. So what really needs to happen for Ashland is it's the top two in 5A and 5B will go to the Zone 5 postseason. Is this is on the ground up the middle, slow roller, gloved by the second baseman. Throw to first, not a problem. 4-3 goes Nick Porter, two away. So if Ashland one out, and of course they have their work cut out for them, that would put them at 10-7-1. Then they would need some substantial help from Newton. And they would need Sudbury to lose a pair as well. But anything certainly possible as that pitch down low. 1-0 to Thurber. Okay, the Zone 5B standings in just a moment. That one outside. In Zone 5B, you got Lowell at top, 12-1. North Chelmsford, 9-5 in second. Bill Ricka, 6-8-1 in third. Tingsboro's out, 2-12. And Medford, 1-15. Wind up and the pitch. Down low. Only one more regular season home game left for post 77. 18 games scheduled this season for everyone in Zone 5 with Watertown dropping at the last minute as there's a strike, 3-1. That was a big surprise, Watertown dropping. Watertown is a big sports town. As there's strike two. Ashland did beat Natick on the road this past weekend, the windup and the pitch. And a breaking pitch that'll drop in for strike three. Brendan Thurber goes down looking. It is a 3-1 Natick lead as we head to the fourth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. Bedding, container plants, vegetables, culinary herbs, bark mulch, firewood, and more. You can find them online at angelsgardencenter.com. As we are ready for the fourth inning, Jeff Haller set to deliver to Jack Fazio, the third baseman. Fazio hit into a fielder's choice his last time up. Wind up and the pitch down low, 1-0. It's 7-8 and 9 for Natick this inning. Fazio, Wilson, and Buschetto. And this is a hopper up the middle, fielded by the shortstop, a 6-3 ground out for Fazio. Nick Wilson will step in. Leg lift and the pitch. There's strike one. Wilson flew out his last time up in the second. Inside, 1-1. Holler deals. That's down low. 2-1. Holler, the leg lift and the pitch. Up the third base side. Fielded by Thurber. Throw to first, two away. 5-3 ground out. That'll bring up Christian Buschetto. Reached on an error his last time up. Also scored a run on the 2-RBI single by Kennedy Wilson. Swinging strike, 0-1 to the lefty. Holler deals. Hit high in the air towards right center. Keim ranges back and makes the catch. Man, can Andrew Keim cover a lot of ground out there. They go down 1-2-3. We head to the bottom of the fourth. It's 3-1 Natick. 3, 4, and 5 due up for Ashland Post 77. Greg Holler, Nick Burns, and Alex Cohen as they look to get something going offensively, trailing 3-1 to Natick. In what really is a must-win game for Post 77. Mooney set to deliver. That one's low, 1-0. Oh no, called strike. Seems like a pretty big strike zone today. Mooney deals. There's an outside ball. Holler struck out his last time up in the first. Wind up and the pitch. That one is just high. 2-1. Mooney to the set, deals. There's strike two on a breaking ball. Here is the 2-2. Liner up the middle. That'll get through for a base hit. A single to start the fourth off for Greg Holler. Nick Burns will now come up to the plate. Lefty steps in. Outside, 1-0. Mooney from the stretch awaits the sign. That pitch dropped a little bit too low, 2-0. Runner leading off of first as Mooney works from the stretch. Checking at first, runner slides back. I think if you're Post 77, you need to play conservative on the base paths here. They're having trouble with the offense. You want to make sure that there's no unnecessary outs as Mooney delivers. There's a strike. A 2-1 count on Burns, who hit a single and scored a run in the second. Mooney from the stretch. He winds and deals. And this is up the first base side, right to the first baseman. And he'll step on the bag for one, throw to second for two. And that is a 3-4 double play. Two away for Cohen. Cohan hit a single his last time up in the second. That is just rough for Post 77. Holler reaches to start things off, and then the dreaded double play. Breaking pitch, nice drop, but still a little too high, 1-0. The leg lift and the pitch. This is hit foul out of play, 1-1. And that almost hit a soccer game over on the football field behind the baseball field here. Mooney deals. And this is hit high in the air towards right center, ranging over and making the catch is center fielder Ryan Welby. That'll be the third out of the fourth inning. We head to the fifth. It's 3-1 Natick. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. You can find them at WebsterFirst.com. Top of the fifth inning, as stepping in for Natick, Rick White, the leadoff hitter. Jeff Haller set to deliver. That one down low, 1-0. Jeff Haller's pitched a pretty good game so far. Post 77 just can't seem to get the offense going. Haller winds and deals. There's a strike, 1-1. White is 0-1 today, walked in the third and scored a run. There's another low ball, 2-1. Wind up and the pitch. Another low breaking ball, 3-1. Leg lift and the pitch. Upstairs and a leadoff walk to Rick White. Hunter Mayer, the right fielder, will now step in. Runner leading off of first, Jeff Haller from the stretch. Runner takes off. Messier throws down, and the throw is good, but the tag is going to be in time. So Rick White caught stealing, and from here, I did not think Porter got that tag, to be honest with you, but the out was given. But I did not have, we do not have the best view here. But it looked like the tag might have missed. Maybe Post 77 got a break there. As this is hit into center field, that'll drop in for a single. Jared Abruzzese will come to the plate. See, that's the ultimate rally killer when you have the leadoff hitter reach and then he gets caught stealing. It's just a rally killer. Could have two on right now. Haller takes a look at first, runner back. A pitch up high, 1-0. Runner leading off of first. Haller taking a long while and time called. Holler deals.
And this is hit in the air to center, right to Keim, and that is the second out. Runner will stay on first. Keim always seems to be in the right spot at the right time. I'm going to bring up Kennedy Wilson. Pitch up high, throw down to first, and it'll get in a right, or almost in a right field, but look like it might have hit the dirt and stopped the roll. No advancement by the runner. Holler delivers just outside, 2-0. Kennedy Wilson's having a nice day, 2 for 2. Hit a single and scored a run in the second, a 2 RBI single in the third. As that pitch gets by Messier, runner was already in the process of stealing second. Three and oh. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. Holler delivers. Hit high in the air toward shallow left field. Porter ranging back, and it'll get above his glove, and a run is in. So that ended up dropping. Rick White comes around to score. That was a tough one to catch. He did not make contact with it. I'm going to rule that a hit. Excuse me, Mayer was the one who came around to score. So now 4-1. As there's a strike to Ryan Welby. Checking at first, runner slides back. And this is hit in the air to center field, deep center field, pushing Keim back. That'll drop in front of the wall. Runner being waved around from third. Keim will throw it in, ball still in the outfield, and another Natick run will score. RBI triple for Ryan Welby. And now a 5-1 lead as head coach, well, at least head coach for today, Scott Soderberg, going to visit the mound and take the ball from Jeff Holler. We're going to have a relief pitcher here. And it's going to be Brandon Wolf coming in. Pitch. I've not seen him a whole lot on the mound this year, but he will relieve Jeff Holler, and we will be back in a moment. New pitcher is Alex Cohen. Brendan Wolf moved out to right field. My apologies. It looked like Wolf was going to pitch for a minute as he stepped onto the mound. That one's fouled away by Kyle Dombowski, but Alex Cohen is the new pitcher. Brendan Wolf taking over in right field. The windup and the pitch. And this is hit high in the air. Foul territory, first base side. Burns chases it down, makes the catch. And that is the third out of the inning. Natick does plate two more runs, and they lead 5-1 as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the fifth inning. Natick leading 5-1. Due up for post 77, 6, 7, and 8. Andrew Keim, Mike Messier, Michael Krupe. Adam Mooney still out there. He's had a nice start so far. Three of the four innings have been 1-2-3. Well, essentially, three hitters at least. Last inning, there was a double play in the middle of the action, as that one is outside, 1-0. Keim has the only RBI of the day for Ashland. He drove in Nick Burns with a single in the second. Wind up and the pitch. A pop fly above the head of the second baseman who calls off Dombrowski, the first baseman, and makes the catch. One away, Mike Messier will come up. And again, bat's a problem for Post 77 in this game. Just struggling at the plate. Messier 0-for-1 so far. There's strike one. Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away, 0-2. Mooney set to deliver. Hit in the air towards center field, right there to make the catch is Ryan Welby, two away. Michael Krupe will step in. Krupe 0-for-1, struck out in the second. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Mooney delivers. And there's a ball. 1-1. Brendan Wolf due up next. Shall Krupe reach? Upstairs, 2-1. Leg lift and the pitch. On the ground up the middle, fielded by Mooney. Throw to first, not a problem. 1-3 goes Krupe, another 1-2-3 inning. It's 5-1 Natick as we head to the sixth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services. You can find them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. Top of the sixth inning, Natick leading Ashland 5-1. Due up is 7, 8, and 9. Jack Fazio, Nick Wilson, Christian Buschetto to face Alex Cohan. Cohan took over in the fifth to get the final out after two more Natick runs scored. That pitch a strike. Wind up and the pitch. That one's down low, 1-1. To start off the inning, Rick White walked, was eventually caught stealing. Hunter Mayer then hit a single. The wind up and the pitch. Down low, 2-1. Jack Abruzzi flew out to center field. Then an RBI single by Kennedy Wilson scored Mayer. Then an RBI triple by Ryan Welby drove in the second run. Gave Natick some insurance. There's a strike, 2-2. Wind up and the pitch up high. And if Post 77 can't pull this game off, they'll be 2-6 at home. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike, one away. 4-3 on the road. Wind up and the pitch. This is hit into right field. That'll drop in for a base hit. It's a one-out single for Nick Wilson. Christian Bachetto will step in. 0-2 today. Reached on an error and scored a run in the third. Flew out in the fourth. Cohan from the stretch. There's strike one. Time called. Cohan winds and deals down low. Runner leading off of first. Cohan to the set. Swinging strike. 1-2. He winds and deals. And this is a liner. That'll drop into left field. Another base hit. Wilson up to second, Bachetto on first. Rick White to the plate with one out. Holler delivers. Liner right side, that'll get through. That's a base hit. Runner being stopped at third, and it's going to be bases loaded. A good throw in by Wolf. A single for White. Wilson up to third, Bachetto up to second. And now Hunter Mayer with a big chance to add some security for Natick. Still only one out in the inning, bases loaded. There's some discussion on the mound with Cohan. We will have action in the Ashland warm-up area. Tom Onzi will get his arm loose in case Cohan really starts to struggle here. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Hunter Mayer is 1-2 today. Had a sacrifice ground out in the third, a single and scored a run in the fifth. Cohan deals up high. Good save by Messier. He winds and deals inside, 2-1. Cohan set to deliver. The leg lift and the pitch. Swinging strike. 2-2. Cohan gets the sign and delivers. Hit high in the air towards center field. Keim is under it. Makes the catch. All runners will hold. Nice job by Keim getting that one in quickly, and that'll bring up Jared Abruzzese. So bases loaded with two outs. Abruzzese is 0-2, walked in the third. Wind up and the pitch. Down low, 1-0. from the stretch. And this is a hit foul. 1-1. Goes over towards us. Cohan winds and deals. On the ground, up the middle, fielded at short by Porter. Steps on second and gets the unassisted force out for the third out of the inning. And we will head to the bottom of the sixth. Natick leading 5-1. Bottom of the sixth inning, Ashland down to their final six outs. 9-1-2 due up. Brendan Wolf, Nick Porter, Brendan Thurber. Adam Mooney out there for another inning of work. Has pitched a great game so far. He's given up one run on four hits. He's post 77 bats, trying to desperately get something going. The windup and the pitch. Hit high in the air towards shallow center field, and there's the first out as Shelby gets under it. Nick Porter will come up. These Ashland hitters, they're making contact. They're just simply not putting the ball in the right place. Mooney to deliver to Porter. That one's inside, 1-0. Mooney has not had to throw a lot of pitches today. If he gets through this inning, it's very possible they'll leave him in for the completion of this game, as long as he doesn't run into any bumps in the road. But it's been relatively quick innings for Adam Mooney and the Natick defense. The leg lift and the pitch. On the ground, up the middle, fielded at short, throw to first, two away. Brendan Thurber now steps in. Leg lift and the pitch. There's strike one, 0-1. Greg Haller due up next. Shall Thurber reach? He winds and deals. Fouled away, 0-2. Mooney deals, just high. 1-2. Mooney gets the sign he likes, down low, 2-2. Mooney. The windup and the pitch. Strike three. And Thurber goes down, and that will do it for the bottom of the sixth. It is the third three-batter inning in a row for Ashland. 5-1 as we head to the seventh. Top half of the seventh inning as Natick will try to add some insurance, leading 5-1. Kennedy Wilson, Ryan Welby, and Kyle Dombowski do up for post 107, the 5, 6, and 7 hitters, or 4, 5, and 6 hitters, rather. Windup and the pitch from Cohan is up high. Leg lift and the pitch. Down third base side foul, 1-1. Leg lift and the pitch. Just high, 2-1. Natick loaded the bases in the top of the sixth, but did not play to run. There's a strike, 2-2. Holler likes the sign and deals. Excuse me, Cohan, and he hits the batter. Ryan Welby will now come up to the plate. He is 1-for-3 today. Hit an RBI triple in the fifth. Runner leading off of first. Outside, and the runner is going to try to steal, and he does. Stolen base for Wilson. Third stolen base of the day for Natick. The 1-0 pitch to Welby. Up high. Cohan from the stretch delivers. Fouled away, 2-1. Cohan from the stretch. Upstairs, 3-1. Mike Messier will come have a discussion with Cohan. No outs in the inning. Runner on second. A 3-1 count on Welby. Will be the second hitter of the inning. Both hitters have had some pretty good battles here with Cohan. He's had to throw a good amount of pitches in this inning so far. That one's fouled away, full count. Cohan from the stretch. Outside, and the runner draws the walk. So a hit batter, a walked batter, no outs, 2-1. Kyle Dombowski will come up to the plate. Tom Onzi was warming up last inning in case Cohan started to struggle. And I think he's going to probably start throwing again pretty soon. Cohan winds and deals. Inside, 1-0. Cohan steps off the mound, takes a breather. From the stretch, nods at the sign. Wind up and the pitch. Liner right to Nick Porter at short, and he makes the catch. One away. Both runners stay put. Jack Fazio to the plate. Looks like Dombowski barely got a piece of that one. Either that or he got it with the top of the bat. Or near the grip, I should say. On the ground, first base side, slow roller on the grass. Fielded by Burns, steps on first. Gets the second out. Wilson moves up to third. Will be to second, but there is two outs in the inning. Nick Wilson will step in. Cohan from the stretch delivers. Up high, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. Up high, got away a little bit from Messier, but he's able to keep it close, 2-0. Cohan set the deal, the leg lift in, the pitch. This is hit in the air. High fly ball, left side foul. The 2-1 pitch. Down low. Three-one pitch, Cohan delivers outside. Wilson gets the pass, second walk of the inning, bases loaded, two outs. Christian Bachetta to the plate. And now, Coach Soderberg going to come out, perhaps take the ball here, we'll see. Messier will also have a visit to the mound. And he won't take the ball, he'll leave him in. Bachetta is 1-for-3 today, reached on an error in the third, scored a run, hit a single in the sixth, flew out in the fourth. Cohan likes the sign and deals. Strike one to the lefty, 0-1. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike, 0-2. Fouled away. Cohan delivers, up high, 1-2. Time called. The 1-2 pitch. Outside, 2-2. Cohan delivers. Inside, full count. To the set, there's strike three. Cohan gets the K and gets out of another bases loaded jam. We head to the bottom of the seventh. Ashland still has some work to do, trailing by 4, down to their final three outs. Post 77, down to their final three outs. Due up are the 3, 4, and 5 hitters, Greg Holler, Nick Burns, Alex Cohan. Adam Mooney back out on the mound, going for the complete game. He has had 4 straight innings in which only 3 hitters came to the plate for post 77. Natick trying to win their 5th game of the season. There's a strike 1. Natick 4-11 heading into today's game. Ashland was 6-7-1. Inside 1-1. This is essentially a must-win game for Ashland. Wind up and the pitch. Fouled away. 1-2. Leg lift and the pitch. Up high. 2-2. Greg Haller started the game pitching. Jeff Haller started the game pitching. Then it went to Alex Cohan. That one's down low. 3-2. Of course, this is Greg Haller at the plate, who played a pretty solid left field today. Up the third base side, throw to first, pulls the first baseman briefly off the bag, but Dombrowski recovers and Haller goes down 5-3, one away, Nick Burns to the plate. Nick Burns 1-for-2 today. Hit a single and scored the only run in the second off an RBI single by Andrew Keim. Mooney delivers. That one's down low, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. Up the middle, slow roller on the grass. Picked up by Dombrowski, flips it over to the pitcher. And they got the out. Nice hustle by Mooney. A 3-1 ground out there. Two away. Cohan will come up. First pitch, a strike. Wind up and the pitch. Fly ball right side. Dombrowski chasing it down, out of play. 0-2. Umpire will dust off home plate. Wind up and the pitch. Upstairs. 1-2. To the set. Slow roller right side. Dombrowski picks it up. Throw to the pitcher. And another 3-1 ground out. And that will do it. Natick takes down Ashland post 77 by a final score of 5-1, certainly a tough loss to swallow for Ashland, but they just could not get the hitting going today. A terrific pitching performance by Adam Mooney as he went the complete game for Natick. And just a rough loss for Ashland post 77. Let's take a look at the recap. We will get right in to it. The first run was scored in the top half of the second by Natick. Kennedy Wilson hit a single and then was later driven in by Kyle Dombrowski. And that would make the score 1-0. Bottom of the second, post 77 responded. Nick Burns and Alex Cohan both reached on singles. Andrew Keim then hit an RBI single to drive in Nick Burns. That would tie the game at one. But then the very next inning in the third, Natick scored a couple more runs as Bichetta started off the inning, reaching on an error by the pitcher, an errant throw. Rick White then walked, and then a sacrifice ground out by Hunter Mayer to push both the runners up. And then Jared Abruzzese walked to load up the bases. Kennedy Wilson then hit a two RBI single, And that is how Natick scored their two runs in the third. So 3-1 after the top of the third. And then the next runs would come once again by Natick in the top half of the fifth. Hunter Mayer starting off the inning with a single. Abruzzese then flew out to center. And then Kennedy Wilson hit the RBI single to drive in Hunter Mayer. And then an RBI triple by Ryan Welby, just crushed a ball over to center field. That scored Wilson, and that would give Natick some extra security, making the score 5-1. Here are the pitching lines. Jeff Haller went 4 2/3, giving up 7 hits, 5 runs, 3 which were earned, 2 walks, and had 1 strikeout. Alex Cohan in relief went 2 1/3, giving up 3 hits, no runs, 2 walks, 2 strikeouts. For Natick, Adam Mooney is your player of the game. He went the complete game, going all 7 innings, 4 hits, 1 run, no walks, 5 strikeouts. Your offensive player of the game, Kennedy Wilson, as he went 3 for 3, scoring 2 runs, had a 2 RBI single in the third, was also hit by a pitch in the 7th, and had 2 stolen bases. Kennedy Wilson, what a great day he had offensively. Well, it's more likely than not that Ashland is likely eliminated from playoff contention as they drop to 6-8-1. But let's not forget, this is a young team. They're developing nicely, and they have been pretty competitive this season. They got 3 more games this week, so hope is not completely over. A lot of things can still happen, but in any case, this Ashland team has really developed throughout the season, and they have certainly improved. And we look forward to watching Ashland throughout the week and seeing if they can get back into the swing of things. But in any case, Natick improves to 5-11. Ashland falls to 6-8-1 as Natick post 107 defeats Ashland post 77 by a final score of 5-1. For Connor Donovan on camera, I'm Tom Nappe. We thank you for watching this broadcast of Ashland Legion Baseball on HCAM in Hopkinton or on WACA in Ashland. Thanks for watching and enjoy the rest of your day.